Korutla Public School. Many ambitions, one destination. Korutla.
Very good morning. Yes, I want to start first lesson in biology. The lesson name is Cell, its structure and functions. Before it, in 8th class, we completed about the cell and its shape, size, what is unicellular organisms, and what is the meaning of multicellular organisms. Okay, we completed this, but in this topic we want to discuss, we have to discuss what are the organelles or what are the parts which present or which consisting in the cell, and how its structure, and what is the main role of, and what is the main role of its. Okay, we have to discuss in them. Okay, we know here unicellular organism is nothing but the organism body which made up of with only one cell or single cell, that is the unicellular organism. Multicellular organism is nothing but the organism body which is made up of more than two cells or more cells. Okay, we call that is the multicellular. This we completed. And in the same 8th class, we observed the onion cell, its a lab activity, and we observed the cheek cell. You know here, onion cell, it nearly rectangular shape. And cheek cell, it's in irregular shape. What is its meaning? The cells which present in the different kind of organisms, not in a similar structure. Okay, they are in difference. That's it. Okay, up to here we completed. Now, it is the time to discuss about remaining parts. And we know here, actually we observe the cell under the compound microscope. By using of compound microscope, we observe only the few parts. Only the few parts. They are nucleus, the cytoplasm, some of the organelles like mitochondria, chloroplast, like this. Parts can observe by using a compound microscope. Okay, once again, the cell structure we can observe easily by using a compound microscope, but we can identify only the few parts, or what are the parts or what are the organelles which present in the cell, we can identify by using a compound microscope. If we observe the cell under the electron microscope, we can see what are the inner parts of nucleus, and how the mitochondria is, and how the chloroplast, and that is nothing but we can see that every organelle in a clear by using of electron microscope. What is its shape, and what are the parts it has, and how they are involved in the different functions. These all can identify by using the electron microscope. So it is the better equipment for clear observation. Okay, now that's it. And now we are going to discuss about the cell, its structure, and some shape and remaining we will discuss. Okay, this is about the 8th class actually. Now, typical cell. Typical cell. Okay, here. In this lesson, we have the two pictures, that is plant cell and another one more thing is animal cell. Okay, in them, they given explanation about these two. They identify plant cells and animal cells and they note down the organelles. What is the meaning of organelles? The parts which present in the cytoplasm of cell are called as cell organelles. They are called as the organelles. That is mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, nucleus, ribosomes, lysosomes, chloroplast. These all are the organelles. And they compare the plant cell and the animal cell. They compare the plant cell and animal cell, scientists. Look here, they identify first plant cell and they note down the what are the organelles in the plant cell. And the same, the scientists, they identify the animal cell and they note down the organelles. And finally, they find out only some organelles which present in some of the parts, plant parts, they are not in the animal cells. For example, chloroplasts. Because we know here the chloroplast is one of the organelle, it involves in the process of photosynthesis. But the chloroplast is absent. So we can't prepare the food or we can't perform the photosynthesis or animals. But that is what this means. Okay, here they compare what in the size, shape and organelles, everything. Okay, that is about. Okay, that is about here the cell organelles. Next one more thing. Here we have to discuss about what, how the cells are made up of, or how the cells means what is its shape, size, and is it has the membrane or is it has membrane and one more cell wall. That kind we have to observe. And the next one more thing, in the cell, if it has the membrane, what is its function and how it performs the activities? Okay, that kind of information, this kind of information we have to read. Okay, now it is the time to discuss about first one, cell membrane. Already we did activity in the 8th class. Again we have to discuss. In the 8th class we did it with the onion. And we observed the cell membrane or cell in the cheek. But now we are observing the cells of a plant. Cells of a plant. Okay, for the observation of cell. First, This activity, it has a procedure. Directly, I am explaining the process. Okay, na? In this, first, we have to take one of the plant leaf. The plant leaf, the plant name is the Rio. You should take the Rio leaf. Rio leaf. Rio plant leaf. Rio plant leaf. Then, take Rio leaf. And next one more thing. Tear it with a single stroke. Take a leaf and tear it with a single stroke. Later, absorb against sunlight. After that, tear the leaf with a single stroke. You absorb the leaf against the sunlight. You should keep the leaf against sunlight and you watch the corner of the leaf. You watch at the corner. At the corner, we can identify a transparent. Transparent membranes are transparent. Portions we can identify. Transparent portion. Then you cut down these transparent portions. Cut it. Then you should take it on to slide. Take on to slide. Take on to slide. Again. Take one of the Rio leaf, tear it with single stroke. After it divides into two pieces or any, in them, you should take one of the piece and absorb against the sunlight. Against the sunlight. Then at the cutted portion or at the corner, we identify that transparent portion. This transparent portion you may remove or you cut down or you separate. Then you take it onto the slide. After you take it on to the slide, okay, here it is a slide. After transfer this transparent portion onto the slide, you add one or two drops of water. By using the dropper, you add one or two drops of water onto this thin portion. Then cover it with cover slip. Cover it with cover slip. Cover it with cover slip. After that, after covering, observe under microscope. Observe under microscope, then you draw the picture what you observe. Means in this thin portion, how the cells are arranged, you draw the picture in your notebook. Draw the rough picture in your notebook. What is this? What is the result? The result is nothing but we observe the cells in the Rio leaf, observation of cells in Rio leaf. Okay, this is actually activity, lab activity. We know here it has some of the procedures. The first one is that aim, observation of cells in Rio leaf. That is it. And second step, materials. What are the materials are needed? The materials are, for every activity, lab activity, we are using that slide, cover slip, watch glass, and brush, and dropper, scissor, needle. Okay, these are. And process or procedure. First, you take Rio leaf, tear it with single stroke, and after tear, observe the thin slices or thin pieces of leaf against sunlight. At a corner, we observe the transparent portion. You separate this transparent portion and you take it onto the slide. After, you add 1 or 2 drops of water and then cover it with cover slip, observe under microscope, then draw rough pictures what you observe. What does this mean? In this rough picture, we can identify and we can observe some of the rectangular portions it has, the rectangular portions which present in the Rio leaf, we called them as cell. Okay, this is about the observation of cell. Okay, that is the observation of cell. We know here, in each and every cell, centrally it has a dark color spot is called as nucleus. Okay, then we know this process. Okay, it is. Now we have to continue activity from here. Okay, here, what we did here, we took a thin slice or thin portion of a leaf onto the slide and covered or added water. Then we cover it with the cover slip. But in the second step, after the draw the pictures or after the observation under the microscope, we do the second procedure. What is the second procedure? In the second method, when you transfer thin slice or thin portion of leaf onto the slide, you add 1 or 2 drops of salt solution. This is the, in the first, we added 1 or 2 drops of water and we covered cover slip and observe under microscope, we draw the picture like this. But in the second method, up to here the same mechanism, same leaf. And next, instead of water, we are changing. What we are adding? Salt solution we are adding. Then after the addition of salt solution, leave it for 5 to 10 minutes. Leave the keep the slide aside and wait for 5 to 10 minutes. And after 5 to 10 minutes, cover it with cover slip. Observe under microscope. Then, same as like here, you draw picture. Here we observe the correct, exactly rectangular shaped cell. But in the cell, we can't see proper structure. What happened here in this activity? The inner portion, the center portion of the cell, it becomes shriveled. Why it shriveled? The inner part of the cell, it becomes shriveled. Why it can't in the first procedure? Why it's happening second procedure? For this, we have to discuss about the salt solution. How do we make the salt solution? For making of salt solution, you take 50 ml of water To this, add 1 spoon of, that may be teaspoon of salt. Then stir well, we make a solution. The solution is salt solution. In this solution, you should add 1 or 2 drops of salt solution to them and leave it for 5 to 10 minutes. We cover it with cover slip, observe under microscope. After observation, we can identify a folded structure inner side of the cell. What is it? Before this, we wanted to discuss cytoplasm. This is the first activity picture. First procedure picture. This is the second procedure. Next, we have to discuss cytoplasm. What is the meaning of cytoplasm? The liquid portion. The liquid portion which present in cell is called as the cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, actually it is a liquid part. What is the use of this cytoplasm? In this cytoplasm, I say some organelles are present. The organelles are cell organelles. Okay, this is the site for cell organelles. Means that all cell organelles are float in the cytoplasm. They all are arranged. All cell organelles are arranged in the cytoplasm. Okay, it is a liquid part. Is it has any shape or any structure? Yes, why not? It has a perfect shape. How it has a perfect shape? Because of the cytoplasm is covered by. A membrane. We called the membrane is cell membrane, or it is also called plasma membrane. Cell membrane or plasma membrane. Have you seen cell membrane or plasma membrane? Yes, we can identify a liquid part here. In them, cytoplasm we can see. And here also we can see cytoplasm. Can you see cell membrane? We called it the cell membrane in the first procedure. Can you see cell membrane? Yes, why not? Here we can see cell membrane or plasma membrane. After addition of salt solution. Okay, we can separate the cell membrane. The cell membrane become folded. Why it is folded? What I say? The cytoplasm is covered by the cell membrane. Here, this is the cytoplasm. Inner liquid portion cytoplasm. It's covered by the cell membrane or plasma membrane. What happened after the adding salt solution? After addition of salt solution, in the cytoplasm, majorly it has the water. Water. In this activity, from the cytoplasm, what are come out from each and every cell? Water release outside or it's come outside. We call this mechanism is exoosmosis. Exoosmosis. What is the meaning of exoosmosis? Here, salt solution outside of the cell. What it has? Salt solution outside of the cell. It has the salt solution. What is the meaning? In the salt solution, salt concentration more. Water is less. What about in the cytoplasm? In the cytoplasm, water is more and salt is less. Exoosmosis is nothing but water it can moves from higher level to the lower level through this membrane. We call that is the exosmosis. Then when from the cytoplasm or when from the cell complete water is released out or come out, automatically the inner structure of the cell it become folded or it becomes shrivel. Then we can see or we can watch cell membrane properly or clearly. In the first procedure we can't see because of here the complete cytoplasm is surrounded. We can't see properly or we can't separate, but we can separate here. Okay, that's it. And one more thing, here is this is the cytoplasm. And this folded one is the cell membrane or plasma membrane. What about the other? Above the cell membrane, another one is covered, that is called as cell wall. Cell wall. Okay? The liquid portion, cytoplasm. The liquid portion covered by the membrane is cell membrane and plasma membrane. This cell membrane is covered by the tough one is called as the cell wall. Cell wall. Okay, these are the parts. Okay, this is about the activity. Now we have to discuss about the cell membrane and cell wall. Okay, this is the difference between the first procedure and second procedure. Why we can see cell membrane clearly? It is by adding of salt solution. It is by the activity or one of the mechanism or process exosmosis. Now it's about what is the function of cell membrane. Cell membrane, it give perfect shape. It give perfect shape to the cytoplasm. And next one more thing. The cell membrane protect cytoplasm from external environment. Okay, it is the cell membrane. Sorry, cytoplasm. Why? When it is covered with the cell membrane, it gives or no one, no, any material can't enter into the cytoplasm. What this mean? It gives protection from the external environment. Harmful substance or virus or bacteria or fungi, nothing can enter into the inner cell because of it is protected by the cell membrane. Okay, I think you get any doubt. Sir, is all materials are entering into the cell membrane, cytoplasm? Now, only few substances can pass through the cell membrane. What does this mean, only few substances? Only that selectively. Which are selected, only the selectively substances, that is nothing but selected substances only can pass through this membrane. Not nothing but only few is nothing but selected substances only pass through the cell membrane. So we call cell membrane is selectively permeable membrane. This membrane, it give permission to only the selected substances. That's why we call cell membrane is selectively permeable membrane. Only few substances can enter into cell, only few can send outside through the membrane. That's why we call selectively permeable membrane. So how it is made up of? The cell membrane is made up of with the lipids and proteins. Lipids and proteins, it is made up of. Okay, this is about the cell membrane. Okay, we completed cytoplasm definition, cell membrane and how it is useful. And next to cell wall. What is the meaning of cell wall? Over the cell membrane, a cell membrane is enclosed by cell wall. Cell membrane enclosed by a tough layer, tough and flexible layer, that is called as cell wall. That is called as cell wall. We know the cell membrane is made up of with the lipids and protein, but cell wall is made up of with the cellulose. So the cellulose is one of the tough substance. That's why the cell wall is one of the hardest material over the cell membrane. Next, look here. What is the use of the cell wall? It is very tough and it is one of flexible layer. What does it mean? It gives perfect shape to cell. And next, the cell wall, it's helpful. It's helpful for the giving protection. It is also one of the protective membrane, or it gives protection from the direct attack of bacteria and fungal attack onto the cell. And next one more thing. It sends the information between the cell. Send information about the growth and development. So it is also one of the important. And next, in the cell wall, it is a porous. What is its meaning? It is a porous layer. Means it has minute holes. By this, it's helpful for the exchange of gases also. Exchange of gases. In the earlier days, the scientists explained it's inactive. The cell wall is inactive over the cell membrane. But now, scientists, by the conducted cell experiment on them, they given this kind of information. It is not an inactive layer. It sends a message between the cell about the growth and development, and it has minute pores on them. It is for the exchange of gases, and it gives perfect shape to the cell, and it protects the plant cell from the invalid attack of that bacteria, fungal attack. It protects the cell. So this is the topic.
Okay. 33 minutes.
I thought for you.